Hey guys.
What's up, coach? Hold on. Hold
What's up, coach? What's going on?
One or two.
How's how y'all doing?
Yeah.
I think it's neat that you guys won a conference championship, and I just want to go back and relive a little bit of it with you.
Oh, we're going to live it for you, coach.
You know, I actually had a chance when I was in college. We went up to UNC Asheville and scrimmaged against UNC Asheville when they were an NAIA school. And believe it or not, their assistant coach was a guy by the name of Coach Green. And we had a big fight that day in the gym. We had a fight. You wouldn't believe it. But I wanted you guys to tell me, what was it like playing for him?
I'll start off.
Go ahead, Slade. Go, Rob.
It was interesting from the standpoint you actually came into practice and never knew which direction we would be headed, which was it kept you on your toes in a sense, you know what I'm saying? So you subject to come out, you have a game plan, or you subject to come out and then you got shirts and skins that day. So either way, one thing for sure, you were going to be competitive that day in practice. So I think that's from my standpoint of it, first jumping into it.
Yeah.
Well, when did you guys think you were good enough that you could win a SEC championship? When did you realize that?
June. Once everybody got on campus.
Once everybody got on campus.
Once everybody got on campus, and we played pickup the first day. That was me. We played pickup the first day, and we separated upperclassmen versus the underclassmen. And we came in and we held our own. And as I'm speaking as the underclass, we held our own. And it was battles. Like, you can see the individual battles throughout the scrimmage. I mean, throughout the pickup game. Hey, man. And that let me know, like, it's serious. And then it wasn't nothing to carry it over off the court.
Right.
Everything, it was bloodshed on the court. And as soon as we stepped outside them lines, it was on. You know what I mean? Everybody was back cool, trying to link up with each other. So that's my perspective on it. That's June.
Yeah, I'm a piggyback on what Ron said. We had a great freshman class that came in that year, coach. So you know, when we, like Ron said, when we was playing pickup, you know, it was literally, you know, a dogfight. It was so competitive that you know, any given day, anybody could have won. Even, like, you know, the young guys, the freshmen that came in, and then ourselves as veterans, you know, they really gave us a run for our money. So at that moment, we knew that we had something special, you know. So we knew that we could really compete in this conference, because this was, it was a tough conference. You know, everybody was loaded. Every year we had at least maybe 6 or 7 teams that qualified for the NCAA tournament, if I'm not mistaken. So it was very competitive. Yeah. And so we knew at that moment that we would be right at the top, you know, of the list of the teams in that conference that year.
Yeah. And the intensity, I mean, the intensity was off the charts. Like they said, coach, from summer pickup to individual workouts to everyday practices, the intensity was always off the charts. And going back to what they said, that we'd walk off, as soon as we walk off the court, jump in the showers, everything was like it was before practice.
Did, when you think back, you know, things are different now. You know, when we get to practice during the summer and all that, obviously not now, but in the past a couple of years, we've been able to do that. Remember when coaches used to do those preseason, you know, we're getting in shape before the 15th started? You guys remember any of that at all, what that was like?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, it was coach, you're talking to a cast of characters, really.
I can see Ron Slay, if you're running around campus, I can see somebody pick him up halfway around the campus and drop him off close to the end. I can see that happening.
Exactly.
Coach, Ron Slay is going to do all the work you want, but Ron Slay is going to eat pizza at night.
Okay, pizza every night.
Each and every night.
Do you think he put on what they call that freshman 15? Did he put it on in about 6 weeks?
I got a quarter, coach.
He got quick. It was quick,
cool,
coach.
Give me a cool quarter. I went and got a cool quarter. Yeah. Put a cool 25 on me.
You guys lifted, obviously. What was that like?
Oh, we got that.
We got after it in the weight room.
Yeah, we had great strength coaches, and you know, like I said, you looking at it like a bunch of competitive people. Mm-hmm. You know, very competitive, and we would encourage, we push each other through encouragement. A lot of times it was through, you know, a lot of ribbing and poking fun of, at each other, but mm-hmm. we always, always pulled the best out of each other.
All you got to do, coach, is look at Marcus Haislip.
Yeah.
You look at that picture they posted, and then you go back and find a sophomore year picture or a junior year picture.
Right.
Hey, the weight room was serious. Why don't we do this? After we get done with this tonight, why don't you guys send me in a current picture, and we'll put them up against those pictures back then, and we'll post them.
Yeah.
Okay. Ooh, okay.
That's probably not the best idea.
Well, I'm looking at this, and I saw where you guys played Florida twice in went overtime games. What do y'all remember about those games?
Man.
I'll tell you what I remember. I remember the year before when we went down there. T. Harris, you was there. Vegas was there. And, man, we got into a fight. It's like I fell into the bench. Two or three dudes kicked me. And, I mean, the guys were so feisty, man. And the year before that, I think Jason Williams was down there the year before that. It had been a long time since we won down there. I mean, it felt like trying to go to Detroit when you was Jordan and the Bulls. In the early ages, I mean, they handle you rough. You wouldn't get a lot of love from the referees. You know how they go home cooking. But then it just felt good. I mean, even it took a couple overtimes to win down there, but it felt good to come out with a win finally down there. It was like the big bad bully. We kind of got the monkey off our back down there.
Yeah, it's interesting that you said that you use that comparison, Zeke, because our freshman year, I remember we went down there when they had Eddie Shannon and
yep.
all those guys, and they jumped out on us 23-2.
Yeah.
Ooh.
We couldn't even
23-2. And we took a lump that night. But as we got older and when we pushed ahead, we ended up coming out on top at the end, you know.
Okay, well, let me ask you this. I'm going to ask you about one team, and I want you to tell me when I mention that team, what player would come to mind, okay? And the first team I'm going to ask you about is Auburn.
Chris Porter. Was anybody else on that team
play?
Scotty Pullman.
Who? That was the shooter,
wasn't it?
Scotty Pullman.
Well, hey, Doc Robinson.
Hey, you guys remember a guy at all by the name of Damian Fishback?
Yeah.
Hey, he told me how good he was now. Go ahead, Damian. You guys.
Hey, man. Let me ask this question. Why I got to be the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th player, man? Remember, brother, I'm on ESPN and SC. I at least thought I'd get before a poll, man. I'm inside Doc Robinson, Chris Porter.
We was going down the list.
Hey, that's why when they invited me on here, I had to be best dressed because I knew I was the worst player out of all y'all, man. It hurt me, man. Hey, coach, I remember all these cats. T. Harris, you know, Isaiah Zeke Victor from Kentucky, C.J. Black. I remember Yarbrough, Slay with the headband, one of the best teams ever. Hey, I do got a quick question. If y'all's team played Tennessee's team of last year, T. Harris versus Bone, Grant, Admiral Schofield versus Black Slay. Who wins and what is the score?
Can we have Coach Barnes as our coach too?
Ooh, you gotta have the best coach in the country.
If we get Coach Barnes, I think we blow him out.
They got a very, very good team. Very good team and a very, very cohesive unit.
Oh yeah.
But these monsters, yeah, I'm gonna be honest. We were going to beat them in the tunnel before it even hit the floor. I'm going to be real.
I believe if it got to the second half, we put the press on them. I seen the ball handling. It wasn't the strongest suit, and we had a real mean press. I mean, beginning of the second half, we was coming out with that press, and if you couldn't handle a bunch of 6'7", 6'8", 6'9", you know, everybody with speed, everybody jumping high, you know, it's – it could have went either way, just because we blew a lot of games too. But I think we got the better roster for sure.
I'm gonna be honest, Zeke. It couldn't have went either way. Not if we got Coach Barnes on coaching us. It's not going either way, because you got to think you got the the leading shot blocker holding down the middle.
Right.
You got the leader in steals on the wing still to this day. Like, it's like, it, hey, man, hey, 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 yeah. No stuff.
Damien,
don't you open that womb up, man. Don't you do it.
Hey, Damien, hey, I asked those guys a question about what they thought about Auburn. If I told you when Tennessee came to mind, what would come to your mind with this group?
Oh, man, tough, gritty champions. You know, that they're part of that last dance generation that we're all watching with Michael Jordan right now. And I believe when they talk about the defense they had, the players they had, I believe it all, Coach Barnes, because when we used to come in there to Knoxville, Tennessee, they used to beat the brakes off of us every single time I came to town. So I'm going with that group of volunteers. As much as I love Schofield, Williams, Kyle Alexander, great team, but I'm going with the old school guys, Coach.
Everything I hear about them, and I will tell you this, I love that era of basketball, like what we're watching right now, the series coming on. And everybody talked about, you guys talked about that, that you guys were a bunch of junkyard dogs ready to bite somebody's head off.
For spot, too. I'm going to be honest. Like, the only thing that could have gotten our way was us.
We had two players to every position. I mean, our bench could have started easy.
That was the thing. That's the thing.
Some nights our bench should have started.
Right. I agree with that. Yeah.
What would you say has been the biggest difference from the time you played to where the SEC has arrived today? Other than obviously the network has a lot to do with it, right?
Sure. The network has a lot to do with it. For a while there, the SEC got down. It was strictly for the coaches. To have the likes of a Hall of Famer like Coach Barnes, right, to have the new coaches that have come into the league, that's the biggest difference. But I still think the SEC, as the guys were talking about before, it was still just so much more physical when we played. The game itself was more physical. Yeah. If you could have went to pick up, I can't even imagine what pickup was like at their place. But when ours, you know, it was Chris Porter, you know, going against Doc Robinson. We had Brian Smith the year before, Mamadou Njai. It was almost like a fight was ready to break out every single day. It was that physical, that junkyard dog. We'd have to break guys up. I would say, though, now – the guys are more skilled at every position. Now, you know, it's normal to have four out, one in, or all five guys who can put the ball on the floor. The game's a little bit faster, and the game's evolved from coaches. So much film. Guys now learn so early in AAU, and the game resembles much more of the NBA game. So that's the biggest difference for me now.
Yeah. With me personally, I would say what I said earlier. I'm not sure how many teams made it to the NCAA tournament from the SEC conference this past year, but I know since the 4 years I was at Tennessee, we averaged at least 6 or 7 teams. So I say the strength, and I know you can attest to that too, Damien, because you know we had, you know, you thinking about us, Mississippi State, Auburn, you know, Florida, you know, Arkansas, all those teams was in a dogfight every night, and guess what? All those teams qualified to get into the NCAA tournament.
No doubt.
So I would say the strength of the conference was major.
Yeah. Yeah. They're trying to get back there now. They're trying to get back there.
Yep.
Hey, Coach, I do have one more quick question. I just want to make sure all the guys are being honest. If you played the team right now in your current condition, who would win?
I think they know the answer to this one. I think
we play half court game.
Hey, you know what I think? I think it's time to kick that Auburn guy off.
I'm gone.
Time to kick him off, you know.
Hey, congratulations, guys. Thanks so much.
Hey, salute, Diamond.
Thank you for stopping in.
Hey, CJ.
Yes.
I got to ask you a question, man. You know, your block shots. You know, E. Ponce tied you this year.
Right.
He obviously the season got cut short by at least one game.
Okay.
You ought to put that in the record book. Should we put an asterisk by it, or should we just put
you might want to put that in parentheses, because technically my sophomore year, nobody want to come to the paint no more. So I actually took the year off. So I ain't even studying what he's doing.
We're gonna keep you at the top, you know, because I don't like those asterisks, you know.
Right. Now, he did a great job. Like I say, he quick off the floor. I mean, at 6'6", you know, that's kind of like a long three. Plus, he got long arms. But I got a little crocodile arm, so I'm at a disadvantage already. But I still had an all-time leading shot block record, too. But he might get that, but hopefully he may twist the ankle or go to the league early. If you say that, I won't have nothing else to talk about.
I like that transparency.
I want you guys to tell me on your team who you would say was the most underappreciated guy. The guy that did yeoman's work, but he just was, you know, every team has him, you know, that just that guy. Who would you guys say it would be?
That's a good question.
Biggest Davis,
for sure. Yeah. For me, it's always been Isaiah Victor. Because he came in, you know, 6'9", long arms, and Kevin O'Neal put him on the block when I always thought it should have been a 2-3. So out of all of us, I feel like he should have been at least the one to go to the league.
I would say Harris. Harris Walker, even though he ain't on right now. Because he had a tough role come field coming off of Mr. Basketball, then to go on the Hargrave Military Academy and having success on both levels, and then coming in a Tennessee native. He was behind Tony Harris, who was All-American. And then John Higgins was shifted off to the point also. So that cut Harris's minutes. And every time Harris came in, he ain't come in with an attitude. And he had plenty of opportunities to go off. So he ain't come in with an attitude or anything. He came in to do yeoman's work, and it paid off in a lot of games. And he was the same in practice. That's one thing about him. The same thing you got in practice, same thing you got in the game with him. So mine would go with Harris.
I want to say something, too. I think we can name several guys, you know, Harris, Vegas, Isaiah, T. Woods. You know, he was a Mr. Basketball as well.
Right.
You know, so I feel like, you know, a lot of guys, you know, we had guys that could play, but I feel like they weren't trusted by the coach. You see what I'm saying? In certain moments of the game, which they should have been. You know, and that's what, you know, that's what camaraderie come from. You got to trust your players. And I feel like, you know, those players I just named, you know, wasn't trusted like they should have been. You know, and I feel like they did a good job through pickup, preseason, and when they got their minutes, you know, they came to play.
Well, tell me this. After practice, what was it like in the locker room? Because I always – one of my favorite things after practice, I love
going down. Oh, man.
What was it like?
It was happy times for whoever won and whoever lost. It was a little bitter, but it seemed like once we took our showers and got out of there, we put it all behind us, and it was party time.
Let's say, you know, everybody had a sense of humor on this team. So it was – you know, anything might have happened in the locker room, you know. But it was all good, clean, fun, man. We was just some young guys who were, you know, had a lot of love for each other. And we just, you know, we had fun. I can honestly say we had fun doing what we did.
Yeah.
You know, we had fun being with each other and winning.
And it was always joke time. Like, I remember saying, Andy Katz was interviewing Tony Harris he might be interviewing Vince. Was interviewing you, Nas, and me and T. Harris in the shower. We used to have these little bitty bars of soap. They used to put like 40 things of soap right there, but they were this little, like the little hotel soap. So we were standing around the corner while they interviewing and pew, skipping them at Andy Katz. Andy Katz couldn't even do the interview, man. He was like, hey. It was joke time for anybody that walked in there. If you walked in our zone, you gonna get it.
You know, it seems like you guys have got a deep connection, and I tell you, the best teams that I've ever coached were guys that had something that went long beyond the court. Would you guys agree with that?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And for a lot of years, I gave credit to because some of us, I know Zeke, Vegas, Tony, we were brought in under Kevin O'Neal. And then we got transitioned over to Jerry Green and then obviously to Buzz Peterson. And I always gave them credit for somehow figuring out the right personalities to put together. But as I got older, you know, I realized it was really about, you know, it was really about us, you know, and the type of people that we were and the way that we were raised and brought up.
I've heard nothing but how tough you guys were. I mean, everybody talks about it. People that I've been here in Knoxville, we talk about your team and how you just rolled over people. I think that's really neat. But the bond that you guys, I would encourage you to stay together, follow each other, because it's a great thing.
Yeah.
Older, you know, to have these memories. And the one thing that I do want to do at some point in time, I wish we could have done it this year, is bring you guys back here and let you obviously see a huge part of what this program is about. I mean, there's very few championship teams that, and when you are one, that means you don't want to ever forget them.
Right, so, right.
Guys would want to come back here and let us honor you guys in a way that I think you should be honored, because what you did is something that there's a lot of programs that have never won a championship. And, you guys, that's something you guys should be really, really proud of. And I appreciate it. But
I appreciate that.
You're always. Thank you, Coach.
The program is built on players, and you're a part of it forever. And I hope you feel like you can always come back. And if you feel any need that we can help you in any way, we're here to do it. And I love you guys. And I have great respect for those that have come before it. And I will tell you this. We talk to our players all the time about what has come before them, because you guys know now how quick it goes by.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they don't understand what the past. And I think it's important that they do. And so every year we talk about it. And I want you guys to know that, because I just think it's important that they realize that all the good that has come before them. And just know that you're a big part of that.